Good morning, my dear students, Romance Level. How are you today? Yeah, good. Teacher Teti still hope you in a good condition. Today, we come back again with the math subject. Today, we study about solid figures. Okay. Apakah kamu sudah siap untuk belajar anak-anak teacher? Teacher berharap semua buku-buku kamu yang kamu perlukan dalam pembelajaran math sudah ada di dekat kamu. Oke? Tapi sebelumnya, teacher mau ajak kamu untuk memulai pembelajaran, kita awali selalu dengan doa. Oke? Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you for your kindness to us, for your love to us, so we can get together to study again about math. Now, dear Jesus, we want to start our lesson today. Please bless us and guide us so we can understand about explanation of our teacher. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray to you. Amen. The first, we want to study about introduce solid. Okay, you can open your textbook page 98. This is the lesson one about introduce solid. Let's we identify the shape make robot. The first shape is triangle, and then the second shape, ayo remember about it, good, circle, and the third, four, and five are rectangle, six, seven are square, and eight, nine are rectangle, and 10, 11 are triangle. Well done, my students. Now we are going to study about solid figures. We are expected to visualize and describe the different solid figures: prism, pyramid, cylinder, cone, and sphere. Before we start, we want to answer this. Imagine that you have an aquarium and wooden box. If we will fill up both of them until they become entirely full, which of them will take more amount of water? Explain. Let's we understand about the questions. Okay. Imagine, bayangkan bahwa kamu memiliki akuarium dan kotak yang terbuat dari kayu. Jika kita akan mengisi kedua benda tersebut sampai benar-benar penuh, yang mana yang berisi air yang lebih banyak? Jelaskan. Nah, itu maksudnya ya. Iya, anak-anak teacher ada yang menjawab, the aquarium has more amount of water because karena akuarium memiliki lebih besar ruangannya. Nah, ini termasuklah bagian daripada solid. Ya, kenapa? Karena akuarium dengan wooden box has a room. Nah, that's we say the box and the aquarium are sample of figure solid. Do you remember what solid is this? Yes, good. This is the rectangular, and the other names we say the box. This book has six faces. There are the first is bottom, the second top, the third left, and the fourth right, front side, and the last back side. So the book has six faces. Now look at this. The box has three dimensional because the box has length, width, and height. So this is solid figures. The rectangular box has six faces and eight vertices and 12 edges. Dear students, do you remember the meaning of prism? Prism is solid figure that has two opposite faces. There are many of kind of prism. The first, you can see triangular prism. Triangular prism, shape of base is triangular, number of lateral face 3. And the second, rectangular prism, has a composite of two rectangular base and four rectangular lateral face, and cube. A cube, a prism with square base and all its face are square. Pentagonal prism has two pentagonal base and five rectangular lateral face. The other of pyramid, there are so many kinds of pyramid. There are triangular pyramid. Triangular pyramid has three number lateral face, and rectangular pyramid has four number of lateral face, for example, and square pyramid number of lateral face 4, and for example this is. And my dear students, the other solid you can find in your textbook, okay, but I will tell you the other solid figures. There are cylinder has two circular base that are congruent and parallel, circle on the top and circle on the base, and then cone has one circular face, for example. Now this is like ice cream. And the last sphere is a curved surface of point that are all the same distance from the center. This is for example. Nah, anak-anak teacher, kita dapat menyimpulkan ya bahwasannya solid figure itu sangat banyak sekali. Oke, kita akan membuat kesimpulannya ya. The first prism, for example, this is and this is. There are four kinds of prism. And then the second, pyramid. Pyramid, look at this. And then cylinder, for example, cone. And then sphere, like this. Okay, now I will give you five questions. Let's we answer together. Identify the solid figure that is presented by each real object below. Write the name of the solid figure on the blank before each number. A gasoline tank. And the second, blank blank blank, a refrigerator. And then an orange, camping tent, and an ice cream. Okay, let's identify the solid figure. The first, what figure? Yes, good, cylinder. Rectangular prism. And the third, sphere, pyramid, and then cone. Good job, my dear students. Nah, anak-anak teacher, kita sudah sampai di akhir. Mari Kita tutup pembelajaran kita dengan doa. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you for your kindness, for your love to us. You have blessed us to understand our subject today. Dear Jesus, we have finished our lesson today in maths, and now we want to continue our activity. Please bless us and guide us. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray to you. Amen. Okay, my dear students. See you next time. Stay healthy and God bless you.